If you don't know where you're going, everywhere will look like it. Until you place a demand from God, this is what I want. If you don't have vision, God does not have anything to work with. You pursue the vision. It is vision that defines what you want God to do for you. Jesus came with a vision. For God to give Jesus speed and be there for him. Jesus knew what he wanted. I lift you to the next level. I lift you to the next level. In Jesus' name. The favor of God. We are going to be looking at two levels of favor. One is with God, another is with man. Two levels of favor. The favor of God and the favor of man. But hear me, the favor, does anybody have the 20 rand note? Listen now, favor is like money, but it's not money. Favor is like money. But this money is incomplete without both sides. It is the both sides of the money that makes it money. Hello, somebody? Are you still here? Both sides of the money, this is what makes it money. Now, the favor of God is one side. Somebody say, I'm here. The favor of God is one side. The favor of man is the other side. Now, it is the completion of the favor of God and the favor of man that makes it favor. I feel what I'm saying. If it is one-sided, it is incomplete. One cannot do without the other. Hallelujah. One cannot do without the other. So every time you hear about favor, the favor comes both sides. For it to be complete, it needs to be favor of God and favor of man. Somebody here is about to receive a double package. If you don't agree, no favor. It comes with agreeing. Like the young man said, he said, I now understood what it is. It is an injustice to God. Hear this. It is an injustice to God that when God begins to bless a man, when God begins to open up a door for a man, he abandons the man and clings to God. Gosh, you didn't get that. So many people come to Christ Ambassador's Church for the favor of God to be complete. God releases his favor. Dr. Idah releases his favor and it becomes a full favor. So many people, after a while, they will think it is only God that blessed them. They wake up in the morning and they decide to sit at home. They decide that they are too busy for God or too busy for the church to come back to church because God has given them one part. God has blessed them. Now they are enjoying the blessing and they don't realize that to sustain the blessing, you still need. Am I talking to somebody? Your favor becomes incomplete. What happens is, if you decide now, oh, things are working well. God has remembered me. God has favored me. You cut off from man.
Yes.
After a while, it is like having 100 ram beer and deleting that side. And every time you are showing people 100 ram, one day you have to show this side. That's where the problem starts. Because this side sustains this side, and this side sustains this side. It is impossible to separate both. God by himself, God by himself, when he needed to save the world from sin, needed man. He needed man. He would have sent his hand in heaven and said, be saved, be saved. No, he said, whom shall I send? Who will go to up for us? Jesus came like a human being, attributes of a human being, to make sure that the miracle of salvation is complete. Somebody said, talk to me, black man. The favor of God must be God and man. There are people that don't have both. Danger. There are people that don't have anyone. Man, no way. God, no way. No favor, nothing. Things, you yourself, you will know that you are in trouble. When you go to a place where they are giving telephones, or they are giving iPhones, or giving gifts, they say, we have 6 phones, or we have 10 phones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. By the night, one is finished. Something is wrong.
Yeah.
You are in a queue. They say, okay, let's check. The first, okay, they send the man. Okay, you come in, you come in, you come in, you come in, you come in. When they get to the next one, they say, it's closed. It's closed. Hey, but I've been here since 2 o'clock. It's closed. No, it's closed. And the man that is telling you is closed is telling you with his eyes open, like he had a problem with you in the night. And as you are begging, the more you beg, the angrier he becomes, because there is something missing in your life. I came as a prophet this morning. Anything that is missing in your life, you shall receive it in the name of Jesus. I say you shall receive it in the name of Jesus. The favor of God and the favor of man. I promise I will give. You don't want it. I came to tell people, I'm telling you. Okay, let me put it in my pocket. At least I fulfilled my part of the deal. Né? I said I was going to give. The power of God, she couldn't take, so me, I can handle it. Let it stay in my pocket. The favor of God all through this month. After we are finished with you, after I am finished with you, anywhere you enter, they will receive you. Anywhere you go, you will enjoy the favor of God. Something unusual will happen for you this month. Those Egyptians that you used to see, you shall see them no more. The favor of God and man. I will deal with the favor of God today. I'll deal with the favor of man next week. Then I'll deal with the favor again on how to walk in favor to make sure that this thing is solid. The book of Genesis chapter 39. Genesis chapter 39. Come on, shake somebody and tell them, my house is going to be bigger than yours. Come on, doctor. See, I know you don't believe me. I know you don't believe me. I know you don't believe me. My car is going to be longer than yours. My car will be longer than yours. My house will be bigger than yours. My wife will be more beautiful than yours. Let's start from there. Then we'll go to Genesis. What is favor? Favor is divine partiality. Divine what? Or we speak in good grammar, partiality. When someone is partial, you see a referee robs you. You want to score a goal, they say it's offside. You score a goal, they disallow it. You say this man is unfair. Favor is divine partiality. God shows partial. God becomes partial. If whether you like it or not, it's not his business. He said, Esau have I hated. Jacob have I loved. Who are you to question me? Hey! Somebody will say, is God unfair? Who are you? Who are you to question whether he's fair or unfair? God is God by himself. Divine partiality. Somebody is about to be favored. I say somebody is about to be favored. Your business is about to be favored. Your career is about to be favored. Your life is about to be favored. Somebody shout, I'm here. It is divine partiality. Did I get the English? My wife, partiality or partiality? Partiality. Partiality. That's why the Bible says your wife shall be a helper. It's not everything you will know. It's my wife. She can't say, but I corrected you yesterday. I paid. Genesis chapter 39. Let's read something unusual here. Go on. And Joseph was brought down to Egypt, and Potiphar, an officer of Pharaoh, captain of the guard, an Egyptian, brought him of the hands of the Ishmaelites, which he had brought down thither. Keep going to verse 6. And the Lord, somebody said the Lord. You didn't hear me. Somebody said the Lord. Somebody said the Lord. I can't. Somebody shout the Lord. Favor must be favor with God first. And the Lord was with him. And he was a prosperous man. A man that is a slave. He becomes a prosperous man in a foreign land. He's from Zimbo. In a strange land. And listen now, and he was a prosperous man. Now listen to this. And he was in the house of his master. I've never seen anything like this. He was a prosperous man in the house of his master. How come? And a slave. Let's read. Verse 3. And his master, this is where it starts now. And his master saw that the Lord was with him. The Lord must be with you. And that the Lord made all that he did to prosper in his hand. Favor with God. Now look at how it changed. Verse 4. And Joseph found grace in his sight. And he served him. And he made him. Not God now. Not God. And he made him overseer of his house. And all that he had, he put in his hands. Hey. And it came to pass from that time that he made him overseer in his house. And over all that he had, that the Lord blessed the Egyptian because of one man. And the Lord blessed the Egyptian's house for Joseph's sake. And the blessing of the Lord was upon all that he had in the house. And even in his field. Verse 6. And he left all that he had in Joseph's hand. And he knew not what he had, save the bread, which he did eat. And Joseph was a goodly person. And well what? the favor of God and man. So many people, in short, there is no man here that has risen that did not have a man help him. You might not be appreciative like some people are not. Some people, when they go bigger, they forget that you kept them in their house, in your house. They forget that now they have 10,000, 15,000. They forgot that you started paying them 500. That without the 500, they cannot get to the 5,000 where they are. Am I talking to somebody? Some people don't know. That God uses man. They become too big. They become too big. What is that pastor saying? He's not my father in the Lord. I know my father in the Lord. And you were broke like a broken garbage when you first came. Me, I remind you. Me? I have the grace to remind you. I say, oh, you are big now. You are big. Do you remember when you first came with Silpas? You were smelling like potato chips. I will remind you of me, because it's easy for people to forget. It's easy. They become bosses. So you tell them sit down, but I'm sending message on a WhatsApp. When you came, no phone. Now you're sending message on WhatsApp. I send you to go and do message. You sit down first and wait for 2 hours. But I was tired. You forgot. You forgot. The favor of God and man. Let me deal with God first. Then next week I will wash your face. Wash your face. You will repent. I will teach you. Yes. Many have missed out. So the Bible says that Joseph came to a foreign land. He came to a foreign land. Every time I preach, I lay my stomach on the floor. Every time I finish, I say, God, ask my wife. I say, without you, where would I be? If it were not of you, the one person that came wouldn't have come. The two people that were here wouldn't have been here. It is not in the eloquence of speech. There are people that can speak grammar more than me 50 times. Their church is still in secondary school. They are still using a school for 5 years, 10 years. It is favor. Am I talking to somebody? It is the favor of God. Somebody will be favored today. I want you to have a change of mind that God wants to favor us. God wants to change our lives. God wants to move us from one level to another. Every time you are, I wrote a message I'm going to preach first week of April. First week of April. I called the message Shine, Shine God. You will understand when I get there. Our God is arrogant. I'm sorry. Not in that bad way. Our God is a poser. You know what a poser is? Yeah. It's English. I didn't speak Japanese. Our God shows off. Am I talking to somebody? Yes. Our God can only show off with humans. Amen. What gives God grace? What gives God the vuma to show off is when he sees his daughter driving an S-Class, driving a BMW. He said, that's my girl. And do you know one thing with God? As you are driving the BMW, God will remind you where you came from. He will say, you are driving a nice BMW. He will say, remember when you could not pay your bills? God. One day, David got up and started behaving like David. He said, you, I took you from the sheep pen. He told him. He said, I took you from the backyard. You, David, you want to stand before me? If I remove my favor from you. Hey, David said, to you, O Lord, have I sinned. I'm sorry. He sent Saul. He said, Saul, kill the cattle. Kill them. Saul said, I kept some for you. He said, hey, you are big now. When I give you an instruction, you don't want to obey my instruction. The same thing with people. They get blessed and they say, this church, all they want is your tithe. All they want is your money. But when you came here, you couldn't even pay attention. All of a sudden, you're earning 3,000 rand. He said, you know, I need to pay my bills. Oh, you have bills to pay now. The favor of God. I came this morning as a servant to impart favor upon you. I said to impart favor upon you. Hear it. The favor of God stands you out.
Amen.
I'm talking to somebody.
Amen.
When you begin to experience favor, the favor of God stands you out. The Bible says Joseph was brought to Egypt. Was he the only one that was brought to Egypt? Inside the Egypt, he was living in a palace, enjoying. The Bible says he was in charge of the field home everywhere. Maybe he was using a chariot. God distinguished him. Somebody's about to be distinguished. Why are you talking like you're suspecting me? I said somebody's about to be distinguished. 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 If you don't know where you're going, everywhere will look like it. Until you place a demand from God, this is what I want. If you don't have vision, God does not have anything to work with. You pursue the vision. It is vision that defines what you want God to do for you. Jesus came with a vision. For God to give Jesus speed and be there for him. Jesus knew what he wanted.